It's Professor Dave. Let's learn about continuity in functions.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We've just learned about a variety of functions, and up until now, they have all been continuous functions. These are functions where there are no gaps whatsoever. Any x value can act as an input, and we get all the corresponding values for the function as a continuous curve. In other words, the function can be drawn without lifting the pencil from the paper. This is true of lines and parabolas and some other kinds of functions. But some functions are discontinuous. Some of these do not have domains that include all real numbers. There are some x values that are not valid inputs, and thus they are not represented on the function. Consider the function 1 over x minus 1. As we already know, x can't be equal to 1, because then the denominator would be 0, and the function would be undefined. That's why this function, when we graph it, is undefined at x equals 1, meaning the function doesn't touch the line x equals 1. Instead, x equals 1 acts as an asymptote. This is a line that is not part of the function, but instead, the function gets closer and closer to the line without ever touching it. We can see that as the function approaches x equals 1 from the left, smaller and smaller changes in x are producing greater and greater changes in the function. This continues towards the limit of negative infinity as x approaches 1. When approaching from the right, it's essentially the same thing. The function goes to positive infinity as x approaches 1. We will talk more about asymptotes later, but even when there are no asymptotes, a function can be discontinuous if there is a jump, or even just a hole in the function. This could mean a function that appears continuous, except that a single point is missing, or one in which it appears that a portion of it has been shifted in some direction. Take x squared minus 1 over x minus 1. If we are clever, we can see that the numerator will factor into binomials and that these two terms cancel, leaving us with x plus 1. Therefore, the graph will resemble the line x plus 1. However, if we return to the original function, there is one tiny difference. Because the denominator can't equal 0, x can't equal 1, and so 1 is omitted from the domain of this function. That means the line will have one discontinuity. There will be a hole at x equals 1 where the function can't be evaluated. Lastly, we can examine piecewise functions. These are when a function is comprised of several pieces, and we evaluate the function differently depending on the number we are plugging in. For example, we can have a function that is equal to 5 when x is less than negative 2, and equal to x minus 1 when x is greater than or equal to negative 2. That would mean that all the way from negative infinity, the function will be equal to 5. So that's this horizontal line leading all the way up to the point negative 2, 5, with an open circle, meaning that this point is not included. Then, from negative 2 until positive infinity, the function will look like the graph of x minus 1. So we can draw that starting at negative 2, negative 3, filling that in with a closed circle, since that point is included in the function. This extends to positive infinity. So here's what we end up with. And that's what we need to know about continuity in functions. So let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.